Welcome to Madison Avenue Presbyterian Church and this special Bach birthday recital. Happy 337th birthday, Herr Bach, and happy 17th year to Dr. Andrew Henderson as Director of Music and Organist here. I'm Mary Huff, Associate Director of Music, and I'm so glad that you are here this afternoon, both in person and on our live stream. I've seen that we have watchers far and wide, even in Canada. At this time, I ask you to silence your cell phones. Please keep your masks covering your nose and mouth throughout the performance, keeping in mind that Andrew and I are removing our masks with a negative COVID test today. If you are not on our Music on Madison mailing list, I invite you to sign up for only the occasional email. We do have concerts this Friday. Juilliard 415 is presenting a concert of Carl Philipp Emanuel Bach's music, and then a week from today at 3 p.m., Mark Molamont, who is a fantastic tenor, is going to present the entire Die Schöne Müllerin. Following the performance, please do come downstairs for a glass of wine or a cupcake or both to greet Andrew. Please enjoy the concert.
Thank you. afternoon. Thank you, and welcome, and thank you for joining me for Bach's 337th. It is the eve of his birthday, and it's a wonderful way to pay tribute to him with this excellent and interesting and insightful repertoire. The piece I just opened with, the pièce d'or, is also known as the Fantasy in G in some of the copies that have come down, and in many ways it's the most festive piece that he wrote for the organ. It's just sort of full of all kinds of fun turns and wonderful things. The next two pieces are a bit of a contrast. I thought I should have a little bit of the serious side of Bach for today. The next piece you're going to hear is a very sweet, a bittersweet piece. It's a chorale prelude on a chorale, or hymn, German hymn, on An Wasser Flüssen Babylon, which is, translates to By the Waters of Babylon. It's a hymn based on Psalm 137, which is a very bittersweet psalm. And it's a very sweet little piece. And you'll hear the melody coming in the left hand and decorated otherwise in a very delicate way. And then I'll follow that with a contrast, the prelude and fugue in C minor, known as the Great Preludes and Fugues in C minor, and it really is. It's a very sturdy, serious piece, but really a fabulous way to show off the very full textures of the organ.
Thank you.
The next two pieces on the program were not originally intended to be played on the organ. The first is called Jesu Joy of Man's Desiring, probably one of the best known tunes that Bach ever wrote. He wrote it to be the conclusion of the first and second parts of a cantata. It's originally for choir and for orchestra, and you occasionally do hear it lifted from that and arranged for various things. You can hear it in all kinds of different guises, but I think it works particularly well as an organ solo. And it was arranged in this case by someone who probably did more than anyone in the 20th century to make the organ popular. He recorded a huge number of recordings and LPs that sort of went everywhere and had a radio show, and his name was E. Power Biggs. And he played, I think, really quite wonderfully. It was a very clean and straightforward way of playing, but it really captured the imagination of many listeners everywhere. So I'm going to play his arrangement of Jesu Joy of Man's Desiring. And the piece after that was actually arranged by Bach to be played on the organ. It was originally written for an orchestra and two violin solos. When Bach was under the employ of the Duke of Weimar, he started teaching the Duke's nephew. And Prince Johann Ernst was actually quite a good musician. And he went to Amsterdam and he picked up sort of the latest music that was available. And he brought back with him a number of things, including the L'estro armonico, or set 12 concertos by Vivaldi. And so Bach obviously got a chance to take a pretty close look at these 12 pieces, and he took six of them and arranged them in different ways. Two of them he took and arranged for the organ. And so I'm going to play the concerto in A minor, originally for two violins and orchestra, but actually arranged for Bach to be played on the organ. He did quite a lot to change it, to make it more like an organ piece, but it still sounds quite a lot like Vivaldi. And just as anyone gets to know something well by taking someone else's composition and not only writing it out, but sort of filtering it through your own brain, he got to learn a lot about Vivaldi and the Italian style. And so it's kind of a combination of Bach and Vivaldi all in one. So first, Jesu Joy of Man's Desiring.
Thank you.
thinking about today's program, I got to thinking about two other composers who were born in 1685. George Frederick Handel was born in February of that year, and Domenico Scarlatti was born in the fall, I think it was October. And so I thought, well, what would either of these two composers play if they were invited to a Bach birthday concert? And so I've selected some representative pieces that work on the organ. I'll first play two pieces by Domenico Scarlatti, who of course was born in Italy, spent most of his career in Spain and in Portugal, and he wrote 555 surviving keyboard sonatas, probably composed for the harpsichord or some version of stringed keyboard instruments. However, we do know that the places where he was employed also had some small chamber organs, and so it's quite likely that he probably played them and may have even played a number of his sonatas on them. So I've chosen two that I think work quite nicely on the organ. They sort of have little fanfare motifs that seem to, I think, translate quite nicely to the instrument. And then I'm going to play some Handel. So what would Handel play? He might say, well, I'll play something that I invented, and that is the organ concerto. He wrote organ concertos to be played during the intermissions of his oratorios when they were being performed in London. And he would sit at the organ himself, and it was sort of an interesting sort of sideshow to watch Handel play his organ concertos in between movements of his concerto, the oratorios that he wrote. And so I've selected one that I have arranged myself. It's one of the F major concertos. Instead of having an orchestra here, I've arranged it so I'll sort of do what Bach did with Vivaldi. I've got everything going between the two hands. The first two pieces by Scarlatti.
Thank you.
conclude today's recital with two pieces. The first is actually not by Bach, but very much in the style of Bach. And in fact, if Bach was around when this tune that you will hear being used was written, perhaps he would have written a trio just like this as well. But Billy Nally was an American organist and also known as a theater organist. So he was sort of a crossover artist in terms of being able to do quite remarkable things. And so I think he was a very talented organist and composer, and I hope that you'll enjoy this if you can figure out what the melody is and can also relate the first line of the melody to what tomorrow is as well. You get to take an extra cupcake home with you. And then I'll follow that with the Prelude and Fugue in C major by Bach, the great C major Prelude and Fugue, which is a wonderful send-off, I think, to get us downstairs to the reception. Thank you very much.